for the first round of the NCAA tournament. The Wildcats had lost in the first round the last 3 years in succession, but against 16th-seeded Cornell, the Cats enjoyed chewing on some tender victuals.
Work hard is what they really have to do.
Put the Rams one home from the inside.
Joe Turner put on an interesting display of offensive rebounding.
Nice unselfish pass to Joe Turner. How did that stay out?
I was out there, I watched the video.
Point win over Cornell came with a price tag. Tom Tolbert wrenched his back in the first half and would be questionable for the second round showdown against Seton Hall. Then something happened to motivate Tolbert and everyone else on the team to be ready for their Big East foe.
Not better than a lot of people are giving them credit for.
The sizable knot formed early. Arizona pounded the ball inside and got Seton Hall's heralded Mark Bryant in early foul trouble. Bryant sat down for 13 minutes of the first half with only 2 points to his credit. With Seton Hall's big man on the bench, the Cats ran wild.
Seton Hall's tentative turnover cost him. This is Kerr.
Tom Tolbert quickly answered any questions about the status of his back. This Sean Elliott assist gave the Cats an eye-popping 20-point lead at halftime. Brent Musburger, are you watching? The Cats continued to prowl and howl in the second half.
Nice tip by Harvey. You're the first to know you're going to miss.
Anthony Cook would lead all scorers with 20 emphatic points. With only 13 seconds left and the Cats holding an 18-point lead, Craig Bergman hit a long jumper that, to him at least, had special significance.
It was a little bit more special for me, especially near the end when I was chasing Bruce Frazier's record and I was 1 point behind.
On its head, and the Cats advanced to Seattle, Washington for the Western Regionals. Arizona would now face the Iowa Hawkeyes for the second time of the year. The earlier hype about Lute Olson's ties to Iowa didn't count for much in this game. The motivation for both teams was to advance to the regional finals and a chance to earn a trip to the Final Four. Reserve guard Kenny Lofton sparked the Wildcats in the first half with 2 steals and 5 points. But Iowa used its patented press to outscore Arizona 11-2. The Hawkeyes were within 4 at halftime. Craig McMillan scored the first 5 points of the second half. Arizona then pulled away behind the outside shooting of Steve Kerr and the inside play of its front line. With a 20-point lead in the bag, Steve Kerr found time to audition for a spot on the Gumby's roster. Harvey Mason did the honors at the buzzer, and the Cats were one step away from the Final Four. But it would be a big step against one of college basketball's perennial powerhouses.
North Carolina, their team is stacked with All-Americans. So, you've got Dean Smith on the bench, and you know that he's going to be pulling the right strings. Whatever strings can be pulled, he's going to pull them.
Arizona pulled the right strings early, scoring the first 5 points of the game. But Carolina's Jeff Lebo teamed up with center Scott Williams for a quick answer. Then the Tar Heels used an aggressive defense and more inside play by Williams to keep the Cats at bay for the rest of the half. At the break, Arizona found itself in a very unusual position. They were behind, but Craig McMillan rallied the Cats at the start of the second half.
McMillan's three. They bang in back-to-back 3-point shot into Kerr.
Mental breakdown.
And McMillan for the layup.
2 mental breakdowns.
Still, there was concern about Arizona's inside game. Anthony Cook had not scored, and the outspoken Tom Tolbert had only 3 points and 1 rebound.
You better get off your duff and start playing the way you're capable of playing.
Dribble gets it.
Colbert's theatrics, overshadowed another outstanding performance by Sean Elliott.
Great move by Elliott.
He led all scorers with 25 points and was named the outstanding player of the Western Regions. In the end, the Cats won this game as they had won all 34 others by playing together as a team. Right now, the Cats had tickets to the Final Four.
Celebration time in Tucson, Arizona, folks. Kansas City.
That don't win the national title.
Now Cook. In the first 5 minutes, the Cats look strong. Anthony Cook and Sean Elliott guided Arizona to a 9-2 lead. Then Oklahoma turned up the heat.
Now what Arizona's going to try to do is throw over the top of it.
And now it's Grace's turn. Two quick steals. First play lock and then Grace.
4 minutes later, Sean Elliott got the lead back.
Now baseline, it's Elliott.
But Oklahoma went on a 22-9 run to take a 12-point lead at the break. Sean Elliott and Anthony Cook had combined for 19 points in the first half to keep Arizona in the game. But Steve Kerr had hit only one of his 6 3-point attempts. It didn't seem to make sense. He had been red hot in pregame warm-ups. Kerr's shooting woes continued in the second half, but Arizona still managed to fight back. Consecutive baskets by Tom Tolbert pulled the Cats to within 7. Then came one of the most remarkable defensive plays of the year.
Six and Lofton goes up for the steal. Bushler to Turner. Here come the Wildcats.
Followed shortly by one of the most stunning offensive plays of the year.
This was a magnificent play by Sean Elliott. Got around Seager, came right down the middle against the defense for the jam.
Then the Sooners got a lucky bounce.
Back with a three and misses.
And the Oklahoma lead was back to 7 points. A three-point play by Andre Wiley sewed things up for the Sooners. Sean Elliott added one more three-pointer to lead all scorers with 31 points. There are always plenty of what-ifs when a team loses in the Final Four. Steve Kerr faced his share of questions head on.
Yeah.